Hello and welcome to the this video in the .NET Crash Course series. And we would like to thank you for stopping by and check out this video. Please remember to check out the link in the description below for the Developer Success Guide, a free course where you will receive a three video part video series in how to become a successful developer. So now in this lecture we're gonna go deep into C sharp and show you some of the language capabilities and how you can program with it. So now, if you remember in the previous video, we have created this console program where we were inputting or outputting some data on the screen of the let's call it operating system. Now, what I want to do with you, I want to go much deeper inside C sharp and tell you more about it. So now, C sharp is one of the leading .NET languages out there, and there are many other languages that you can use. There is VB, there is F sharp, and Visual C++, and all these languages have something in common, and also some other different capabilities that depending on your use case you will be using different languages, but C sharp will be more than enough to use and learn, and I've been using it for many years so far, and it done really well, and it's still growing and growing. So now let's talk more about how we can define a variable in C sharp. Now, a variable in C sharp is a place in memory where we store the data temporarily in the application. So, for example, if I want to create a variable that store some numeric number value for me, I use the integer value where we can store it. So now I'm gonna create this integer variable and I'm gonna call it var1 and I'm gonna give it the value of 5. Now, as you can see, if I hover over it, it says that this is a local variable. Its name is var1, as you can see over here, and it just show me, if you notice this squeaky line, it says that it's not used. You're just defining a variable and you are not using it. It's just giving you a tip. Now, what we wanna do, we wanna declare another variable. I'm gonna create variable and give it some different value. Now, to assign a value of a variable, we set the data type of the variable, we add the name of the variable, and we give it the value. Now, you can also do like this. You can come over here. Let's say I want to declare variable 3 and give it value 7. I can do same line variable declaration, where the compiler will understand that this is also an integer variable and I wanna give it a value. Now, this sugar syntax, you're gonna see it a lot in C sharp, where it can shorten the needed time for you and your work in programming with C sharp, and that's one of the nice feature of C sharp. Now, what I wanna show you as well is that we have other different types of variables that we define over in C sharp. Now, variables can have some string value, so I'm gonna call it my name and I'm gonna give it maybe Joe name, although my name is Amar, not Joe. So now, as you can see, this is a string variable where I store a string variables inside it or the string values inside it. And if I like, if I hover over here, it shows that it presents me a subsequence of UTF-16 code units, which means that it can store other languages, not only English as well. And as you can see, like I give it a name and so on. Now, there are some rules for naming the variables. For example, like you can't start your variable name with a number. You can't start it with a special character. You can start it with an underscore, but other than that, like you will not be able, like if you used some other symbols, like it will show you an error as well. So now I want to give you some more informations about variables. A variable value will, or sorry, if the variable default value, like this, if I have my variable over here and I create it over here, the variable value will be like by default 0. I'm trying to look for you for the constructor, and we're gonna know more about the constructor in just a bit. So like I can't seem to see the constructor over here for the end declaration, but I'll tell you what I mean right now. So I have the integer variable over here. If I don't declare value to it, okay, and I try to type its value for me, I'm gonna say var2. Okay, this, as you can see, like it show me an error because like I am trying to like use the variable before it's assigned. But like the value of the variable over here will be like the default value for the struct for the integer. So the value over here will be 0, but like I can't, let me try like this, I can't use it unless I assign it. But I can do something like this. I can say default, and the default will create the default value for me. And if I run this application, I shall see a 0 value printed on the screen for me, as you can see over here. Now what about string? Now let's try like this. As you can see, we can't also use a string, but if I give it a default value over here and I run this application, it's like you don't see it, but it's like if I give you the breakpoint over here, notice that we can get a null. Okay, so now let's stop this. So you need to know the default values for the variables if you like are using it without assigning. Also, we have, if you notice over here, we can define our variable on the class level, not only inside the function level, if you want to give it like a higher level of access and so on. This is just like we're gonna see more about it when we talk about the classes in just a short bit. But know this, that your variable value will go away when the execution finishes of the application. So like your application will not store the values if you do like this. if you say var2 equals var1 plus var3, okay, when your application finishes off and go out of a scope of this curly brace, the value will go away. And that's like one of the way C sharp manages memory for you. It's a managed code for you. It manages the memory and allocation by itself. And that's a really long story. I don't want you to bother it with you. But now I want to give you some nice information that you will like if you became a .NET developer and so on. You will like you will be asked about it. The integer, if you notice over here, and if we hover over it, notice that we have int over here. But actually int, if I press F12, it take me to this struct, which is almost a class. So int is actually int 32, okay? And if you notice from the description or the tooltip, it represents a signed integer, and this is just like an alias for int 32, just to make it shorter for you. The same thing for string. If you notice, a string is actually a class. If I go to it, this is actually class string, as you can see over here. This is the entire class. Okay. And don't worry, like about this code, you will not have to deal with it. Just know that the string small letter is just a representation for the class in the string letter. Now, where the value, and that's also a C sharp interview question, and you will encounter this throughout your .NET career. Where does the value stored for the variables? Now, these variables are called value type because it's stored on the stack. Now, the stack is the, let's call it the short term memory for your application. Okay. And the stack will hold your variables and so on. Your reference types, okay, will be on the heap. And like you don't really need to know everything I'm telling you now. If you want, in the description below, I am creating a .NET bootcamp that's starting very soon. Just go down to the description link, sign up for the email via the landing page. You'll receive the developer success guide, and also I'll send you my upcoming bootcamp course to become a .NET developer. Now, let's come back over here. We said that this is getting stored in the stack because like it's a small value, and like you wanna like it's in the stack and you wanna access it as fast as possible. It's not like a reference type. Now, what I wanna show you as well for the variables, as you can see, we can do assigning for the variable from other variables. We can assign the same thing over string. Like if I come down here, create a new string and say this is string d maybe, and this string is y, and I can like concat the following. Now notice this represent concatenation. It does not represent addition operation, so be careful about that. Some questions might try to fool you and put two strings like this, 5 and 10. Now you will think that because it's an add operator, you will think that, oh, it's need to be 50. No, it's not. It does some concatenation. So it will be 5, 1, 0. So be careful about that and understand what's the operator can do. Okay, now that's just a really quick introduction for the variables. Now let's talk about C sharp classes. And a class, as you can see over here, it's a collection of related operation and related data that represent a certain entity or a person or a thing in real world. For example, I'm creating an animal application, okay, or to manage maybe a pet store. So I have the animal entity which represent an animal. Also I can have the dog entity which is also an animal. Okay, so now I wanna come down here, hit right click and add a new class, and I'm gonna call the class is a student, my favorite example. So now the student class over here, I'll add to it something similar to a variable as we seen earlier, but I wanna like show you more things. So now I'm adding a property, and this property I can set its type. So I'm gonna say string, and I'm gonna give it the property name of name. So I have this string property. Now when we say a property is something that you can set its value and get its value. Okay, and we usually use the properties to like protect our data from some certain write and read operation if someone access our application from the outside world. So now this is my class and it's a student class. Now I'll do this class as public, and this is, if you don't know what's this is what's control your visibility for your different classes and different application members. Public means it's anybody can see this class, even the outside world. Like a code, but not everyone who's using the application will be able to see it. Okay, but like if you give someone your assembly and so on, public means that anyone will see the class. And there are some different other types of the visibility for us. Now what I'm gonna do over here, let me just remove all this. I'm gonna come down here and create a new student, and as you can see, Visual Studio can give you some really nice autocomplete. And over here I have created, and now this is another question that you will be asked a lot on .NET world. This is a reference type. It's store the data on the heap of the of the memory. And when we say reference type, this variable of type student does not contain the data. It contains a pointer to the data on the heap memory. So it has like a certain address where, like when you access this student like this inside your application, you accessing actually the memory location, not a direct value. So now after I added the student, I'm gonna come down here, add this property name. I'm gonna come down over here and print out the value for you. And we're gonna add a breakpoint just to show you what is going on. Now, if you notice, here is my student. And the reference type default value is null. So now if you notice, I have this student object, and I have created a new object of the student, and notice that I can see the properties of my C# class, and notice that the name does not have any value and it's null. So if I continue my execution, notice that I can see the value of my property has changed and it will be printed on the screen. So let's close this. So that's how you define a C# class. That's how you add a property to it. And you will be using C# classes whole a lot of time. So now, what we wanna do as well, we wanna add this. Let's call it H. And now I wanna add a new method inside my C# class. Now a method is a collection of repeated operations that you want to have in a single place, and that will be like this. I'm gonna just make it really simple method, and I'm gonna say print details. So this print details method will do me the following. It will call the console. Okay, and from the console I'm gonna print out the details of the student. So I'm gonna say hello, the name of the student, your age is, and I'm gonna print out the age. So I have here my method. I have here that it's printing the name and the age for me. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna add this new property and set its value. So I'm gonna say maybe the age is 22, and I'm gonna do the following. I'm not gonna call the console.writeLine, I'm gonna call print details. Now as you can see, my print details is a method that contains a code that I might be using repeatedly. Okay, so instead of me repeating the same code all over again, I just place it in a single function inside the class, and each time that I need it, I'll call it. So I'm gonna come down here, I'm gonna just remove the breakpoint and run the code for you. And notice with me that we have the value printed with the name and age for our own student. So that's how you define a class and how you add methods to it. And this is a quick C# introduction that we will be need to understand and know, especially in the next few lectures. We will go much deeper on .NET, and I want you to understand these basics so you can get more advanced with us in C#. And again, please check the description below to sign up for our developer success guide, and also for more information on our own .NET development bootcamp. So thank you for watching. Hopefully I will see you in the next video.